Hey guys, welcome to the post-race review here on My Corvette Life. This is going to be a new segment here on my channel. I'm going to be reviewing each race that Corvette Racing goes to in the IMSA season and at Le Mans, and who knows, maybe even in WEC here in the future. Today I'm going to be reviewing the race at Road America. This is the ninth stop for IMSA on their 2017 calendar. Corvette Racing had high hopes going into this race. A couple races ago, they had a bump in BOP. They got a little bit more horsepower. They didn't really get to stretch their legs at Lime Rock Park. It's a pretty small track. But going into Road America with the long straights, they were hoping to get a good result. And they were looking pretty decent in practice, even topping the charts in a couple of the sessions, I think. But when qualifying rolled around, they were thrown a big surprise. They were 2 seconds off pace with the pole-setting Ford. Now, I know a lot of you are going to say, BOP. And this time, I agree with you. That is absolutely ridiculous. I haven't seen anybody in the GTLM class be that far off pace in a lot of years. This class is known for being super competitive, super tight, and even on a track as long as Le Mans, we haven't seen that big of a gap in a long time. Now, normally at Road America, the gap might be a half a second or less from pole to seventh or eighth in class. 2 seconds is really far off pace. So the Corvettes qualified 7th and 8th, which is dead last in class. Even the gap to 6th was 6-tenths of a second, which is massive. So that tells you there's definitely something off with the BOP. They may have had a little bit of a setup issue as well, but even that isn't going to make up that big of a gap. That's just massive. So knowing that, the team obviously had to put their heads together and come up with some sort of strategy, but unfortunately, even strategy can't overcome that big of a pace difference. There were a few incidents in the race. One of the BMWs had a broken suspension earlier in the race, which helped us move up the order a little bit, get some more points that otherwise we would have never caught up to them. And then we kind of shot ourselves in the foot. The three car hip checked the 911 Porsche into turn one, put them in the gravel trap. Here's a few pictures of that. So the three car served a penalty for that. That put them at the back. And then near the end of the race, the number four car, along with the BMW that had an incident earlier in the race, the BMW actually dive bombed the number four into one of the turns and absolutely took out the Corvette. It was pretty blatant. I have no idea how IMSA didn't call a penalty on the BMW. That's just bonkers in my opinion. No clue. That was just dumb. So if they're calling that a racing incident, then the incident with the three tapping the Porsche into the sand trap, that was a lot less obvious, and the Corvette got a penalty for that. So they really need to get their act together as far as penalizing whoever. So after all said and done, the number three car finished fifth, and the number four car finished in last place, in eighth. Somehow, the three still is in the points lead for the Drivers' Championship and the Team Championship. Although Ford has surpassed Chevrolet in the Manufacturers' Championship by 1 point. It's gonna be a tough end of the season. We got three more races to go. VIR, Mazda Laguna Seca, and Petit Le Mans. Hopefully we get some BOP breaks. Who knows? That seems to be the way IMSA rolls these days. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, give me a big thumbs up. If you're not already subscribed, hit the subscribe button. If you want email notifications for every time I post, hit the bell next to the subscribe button. And we'll see you guys later. Thank you.